شهید و محدودیت های توافق هسته‌ای بس. این محدودیت ها باید برداشته بشه.
Following the assassination of Iranian scientist Mohsen Fakhrizadeh, there's been considerable anger here in Iran. Protesters gathered outside parliament and called for revenge, but the anger and frustration goes much deeper than that. This latest assassination has shown the political differences within the political factions inside the country. President Hassan Rouhani and his reformist supporters want to wait and be patient, a strategy called strategic patience. They want to wait until Joe Biden enters office and hope the United States will lift sanctions and rejoin the 2015 nuclear deal. The conservatives, however, who have a majority in parliament, have never liked the 2015 nuclear deal. They thought Iran should never take the West at its word. They believe the country should stop IAEA inspectors from the country. That's the only thing that's really left of the 2015 nuclear deal. That's after Iran began to reduce its commitments as a response to the United States pulling out of the deal and imposing sanctions. Currently, IAEA inspectors can visit nuclear sites inside Iran without any prior notice. But that could change if the Conservatives put a motion to Parliament forcing the government to take action. But there's a much more pressing issue. Core supporters of the Islamic Republic have had enough. They believe strategic patience has only emboldened Iran's enemies and allowed for brazen attacks such as the assassination of Mohsen Fakhrizadeh. They want Iran to strike back and strike back hard. And of course, they want that response to be against Israel. Iran suspects Israel is behind this latest killing. Israel has been accused of killing scientists in the past, mainly four scientists between 2010 and 2012. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu named Mohsen Fakhrizadeh back in 2018, saying that he was the director of Iran's nuclear weapons program.
A key part of the plan was to form new organizations to continue the work. This is how Dr. Mohsen Fakhrizadeh, head of Project Ahmad, put it. Remember that name, Fakhrizadeh.
Also, Israel has always opposed the 2015 nuclear deal, and recent suspicions of Israel meeting with Iran's regional rival, Saudi Arabia, has also increased suspicions that Israel is behind this recent attack. The United States has also expressed its desire to make things very difficult for Iran before President-elect Joe Biden comes into office. They've increased sanctions against the country. Where does that leave President-elect Joe Biden? Well, he's expressed a desire to rejoin the 2015 nuclear deal. But even before he takes office, future talks could be very complicated or a non-starter if the situation escalates. For now, the world is watching and waiting for Iran's response and hoping that Iran shows some restraint. But we don't know where, when, and what form Iran's response will take.